God will heal your lands. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land. That's the New International Version. We often use this scripture when our nation is in trouble and we are praying the Lord to intervene and cause healing or restoration to occur. We confess our sins and those of our fellow citizens. We plead with the Lord to forgive us, have mercy on us, and bring about a turnaround for good in our nation. We want the Lord to heal our economy, the state of the church, our government, and all other aspects of our life as a nation. However, God is also interested in healing other types of land and keeping them healthy. For instance, speaking about our Lord Jesus, the prophet Isaiah said, "But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed." That's Isaiah chapter 53 verse 5, the New International Version. And 3 John verse 3, verse 2 says, "Dear friend, I pray that you may enjoy good health and that all may go well with you, even as your soul is getting along well." Again, that's the New International Version. From these scriptures, we can tell that it is not God's will for his people to be sick. And when we do get sick, he wants to heal our body. In Job chapter 1, we are told about how Job lost his businesses and investments, among other things. Then in Job chapter 42, verses 10 to 12, we learn that after Job had prayed for his friends, the Lord restored his fortunes and gave him twice as much as he had before. All his brothers and sisters and everyone who had known him before came and ate with him in his house. They comforted and consoled him over all the trouble the Lord had brought on him, and each one gave him a piece of silver and a gold ring. The Lord blessed the latter part of Job's life more than the former part. He had 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, and 1,000 donkeys. That's the New International Version. God healed Job's finances and restored his wealth. And in Joel chapter 2, from verse 21 to 27, he promised to do the same for us. "Don't be afraid, O land. Be glad now and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. Don't be afraid, you animals of the field, for the wilderness pastures will soon be green. The trees will again be filled with fruit. Fig trees and grapevines will be loaded down once more. Rejoice, you people of Jerusalem. Rejoice in the Lord your God, for the rain he sends demonstrates his faithfulness. Once more, the autumn rains will come, as well as the rains of spring. The threshing floors will again be piled high with grain, and the presses will overflow with new wine and olive oil. The Lord says, I will give you back what you lost to the swarming locusts, the hopping locusts, the stripping locusts, and the cutting locusts. It was I who sent this great destroying army against you. Once again, you will have all the food you want, and you will praise the Lord your God, who does these miracles for you. Never again will my people be disgraced. Then you will know that I am among my people Israel, that I am the Lord your God, and there is no other. Never again will my people be disgraced." That's the New Living Translation. God is also willing and able to heal and restore marriages, friendships, and everything else that ever gets broken in this life. He even heals broken relationships between himself and humans by drawing sinners to himself for salvation and bringing backsliders back into his fold. Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 22. "Return, ye backsliding children, and I will heal your backslidings. Behold, we come unto thee, for thou art the Lord our God." That's the New Living Translation. If we want God to give us any kind of healing, however, we must follow the same principle highlighted in 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land." That's the New International Version. There are Christians who blame others for every challenge they face in life. Someone else is to be blamed for their health issues, failed marriage, the loss of their job, or the problems they are experiencing in their businesses, and so on. If they are not blaming their friends or associates, they are blaming witches, wizards, and demons operating in their hometowns or the area where they live. Some even blame God, wondering what he was doing that he couldn't stop the enemy from tampering with the blessings he had given to them. Meanwhile, what the Lord wants us to do is first humble ourselves. One of the things you do as you humble yourself is to look inwards and allow the Holy Spirit to reveal to you if and how you went wrong, what you could have done differently, and how you caused or contributed to the problem at hand. If there is any such thing, the Lord will reveal it to you as you humbly seek His face. Then you repent and ask for forgiveness and for God's merciful intervention. If, on the other hand, there is nothing you did wrong and what is going on is purely a spiritual attack, the Lord will reveal that to you. He will also expose to you the tools He wants you to use in playing your own part while He fights for you. That tool may be some specific prayers He wants you to pray, a psalm or more that He wants you to pray with, or a scripture He wants you to quote. He may even ask you to just give Him quality praise and worship while He sorts things out for you. Apart from humbling ourselves, praying and seeking His face, the Lord wants us to turn from our evil or wicked ways. Sometimes all it will take for peace to be restored in a home that's about to collapse is the wife becoming submissive to her husband, or the man resolving to show more love and understanding to his wife. The wicked way God wants you to turn from in order to receive healing in your body may be your careless consumption of food items that are not good for you, and you know that they are not good for your health. The wicked thing a person asking for financial healing will be required to turn away from may be his or her wasteful spending, borrowing to live a big lifestyle that he cannot afford, or investing in businesses that God is clearly warning him to stay away from. God wants to heal all our lands that are sick. Let us cooperate with Him by playing our own role. May the Lord help us all in Jesus' name. Amen.